it's Judy here, and welcome back to Animal Crossing New Horizons. So last week we created this little lavender field. You can see we have little lavenders mixed in with these umbrella bushes, and if you want to see how this was created, I'll have a link to that video in the top right corner right now. And today we are going to be continuing this area, so we're going to be creating a little flower shop right here, as well as finishing a little cargo export area so we can import and trade flowers with Red. Now the supplies that we're going to be using for today's video are
a beekeeper's hive, barbed wire fencing, floor-laid hyacinth lamp, stall, street lamp, rope fencing, cardboard box silo, scarecrow, wooden bucket, simple panel, barrel, wasp nest, cardboard box, oil barrel, and a beekeeper's hive.
I'm also going to have all of the maker addresses to the codes I use on the screen as they're used. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is placing a little stall to be the venue. I'm not sure if that's the right word. Like the counter of the shop. That's definitely a better venue. That doesn't even make sense. And then what I'm going to do is place two stalls behind it. And I have these customized so it looks like shells of lavenders, which I think is super cute. And it definitely matches the vibe, you know? It makes a lot of sense that when you're at a lavender shop, they'd have little shells of lavenders. Next, I'm going to place one hyacinth lamp on the table to act as a lavender. So it's like they picked one of the lavenders from the field here, they put it in a vase. I mean, if I had a lavender shop, I would totally put one in a vase for my countertop, just like that. Next, we're gonna place a barrel right over to the side, nice and cozy. No. Right up to the side, okay? We're friends here. We don't need to keep our distance. Go on, go right up against that stall. There we go, nice and cozy, yes. And then I'm gonna place a little beehive on top. Because it just looks cute, you know? We care about our pollinators here, so it's honey that we use to feed the bees. And speaking about the bees, so something you should consider when working with a tight space like this is how can I be creative about the placement of objects? Because I knew I wanted to add little beehives to this area, but there's only like nine flowers, three in each row, and I didn't want to really take away a bush to add a beehive or something, and then I realized, what about the cliffs? What if there's just happy little bees vibing in the cliffs? So that's what I thought would be kind of like a cute way to still bring them into the design, but without compromising the tight space we're working with. So we're gonna place one little beehive right up there, and then you might have noticed that the waterfalls were trimmed when I started the video. That just makes this process a bit easier. And then let's add one more beehive to the cliff on this side as well. Now, even though the beehives are going to be in the same spot on each side, to make them just a little bit less symmetrical, I'm going to have them facing different directions. So the one on the left side is facing towards the side. On the right side, we're just going to have them facing straight forward. And then let me just fix the waterfall real quick. Beautiful. Alright, so now we have our counter space, we have our little bee friends, and we have some food for them, so that is absolutely great. Now, because we've already begun collecting some of our lavenders, we are going to start having some crates of them. So I'm going to place a little lavender crate right here, as if it's something that we've been collecting for quite a while. There we go. And then I'm going to place a little barbed wire fence here, and then on this side as well. And I feel like that just looks really cute, like you're walking across this little bridge between the stream to get into the flower shop, and then you walk through this little fencing to leave it and head onto the beach area. Now, one more little detail I'm going to add into the shop is just a little bucket. I'm going to place it right up next to the waterfall as if you've been collecting water from the stream in order to water all of the flowers, because I think that's quite cute. And then one more little detail within the flower field is I was thinking we might need a scarecrow. I mean, we don't want birds messing with our flowers anytime soon. Not that we don't love birds, but we don't really want them to be harming our lavenders. Now, as one final detail to the shop, I think we should just place this little lavender sign right here. We can display it as a painting. And then we have this really cute little sign indicating that this indeed is our little lavender shop. So that is pretty much all we're gonna do for the shop. Actually, one more thing, let's throw in a little floor light. You know, it's gonna look really pretty at nighttime. Where is it? Here it is. There we go. We'll put a little floor light between the gates. It's kind of like, you know when the exit sign is illuminated in a shop at nighttime? You don't wanna get trapped in here at night. I mean, you might be able to figure out the way between the fencing, but if you can't, the floor light is here to guide you. And I am pretty happy with the way that looks. I think it looks really cute, really cozy. And now the only thing that's left to do is start working on the cargo area back here. So the very first thing I'm gonna do is place down some metal sheets. Because usually when you're at a ship at a cargo point, there's just a lot of sheet metal, a lot of crates. So let's start off by placing just like a little square of this. There we go, we can place a little bit of metal here. I'm gonna place one more little piece of metal on this side here. And if your secret beach has a similar shape, feel free to follow along. All right, so now we're gonna get a little creative. So in the back corner here, you can't place custom designs back here where the waves are, but you can place fencing and objects. And I feel like that is really, really cool. So the first thing I want to place is a little oil barrel, and I really like the color. It has this sort of coppery tone, and I feel like it's a nice backdrop for everything that I've built up here. So that's why I like that item. And then next to it, I'm going to be using a little bit of rope fencing, and I'm just going to create a frame around where Red's boat would usually come. So usually it docks right about here. So this is kind of like the little guardrails leading you up to his boat. I still want it to be accessible, of course. And then in front of it, I'm gonna place down some little wooden planks across the sand. So it's like, this is where you are meant to walk. Kind of just making that more clear. And then as for this little patch, the first thing I wanna put in is a street lamp, because I feel like this would look so cool at night, and it gives it kind of like an old town vibe, which I really, really love. And then next to it, I'm gonna place down a little flower crate. So we're just gonna pull back our umbrella pattern again, just like that. And you can really get a lot of creativity with these umbrella crates. Like over here, it almost looks like a display in the front of the shop, but back here, it is representative of like true cargo, which I think is really cool. So let's place a cardboard box, just like that. And I'm gonna place one more crate on top of it, just to add a little bit of dimension. And I really like that. So another tip when designing is try to work with like different heights, different like ways of layering objects, you know, like put the panels behind the stall, put a crate and a barrel in front of that, put stuff on top of the barrel, you know, like lots of little details and layers really makes the area come to life. So you can see here, we have this height difference between the crates, but also just having the crates layered on top of each other makes them so much more interesting than just having a crate. And I'm gonna do a very similar thing on this side. I'm gonna place down another cardboard box, and I'm gonna place a flower crate on top of this one as well. Then I'm just gonna flip it around so we can see it. And then right behind it, in between it and this fence, I'm gonna place down another one. And actually, I don't want it to be separated like that. I really like how they overlap with each other, so I'm gonna give it a little push. I feel like that just adds a lot of dimension and depth to your design, and it's definitely something that I love to do personally with everything that I create on Seychelle. Now, I wanna put a silo here, but I thought about it for a while, and I was like, I can't just put metal here and put metal under the silo, because why would the silo be on a metal plate? Like, are you gonna be lifting the silo and putting it on a ship? Probably not. I mean, maybe, but probably not. And then I thought about it again, and I was like, would you put a silo on sand though? Like, it's gonna sink into the sand. I don't know, it just doesn't seem like a very stable foundation. So I figured we could place this little stone pattern here, which could act as concrete and a much more stable foundation for our silo, which is probably a good idea because I don't think it would be good if the silo just toppled over. So there's a nice little foundation for it, there's our silo, and that is our cargo area. And that is the final look, so here is our little lavender farm. I'm so happy with the way that it has turned out ultimately. I love the little flowers here, a little scarecrow friend, the bees in the cliffs, I feel like those look super cute. Our little shop here, I really love it, it looks super super cozy. And this design back here, I feel like it's gonna look so, so cool when Red is in town, when his little boat is back there. I cannot wait to see it. And I mentioned this in part one, but every single time Red came, my little secret beach area used to be pastel pink and white, and it would just destroy the aesthetic. So I'm so excited now to have this more nautical theme that actually looks like a boat belongs here. I feel like it's gonna look so much cooler now, so I cannot wait to get a visit from him. But that's all for today's video, so I really hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that you found the design tips helpful. I hope you can get some inspiration from it. And also, now that we've completed this area, we need to start working on something new, so let me know in the comments below what types of builds you'd like to see next, and we can start working on those. I will see you all very, very soon. Thank you so, so, so much for watching. Bye, everybody!